Mathis, you may open.
Mr. Speaker, members, AB661 provides cleanup language to promote uniformity, eliminate confusion, and ensure a smooth real estate transaction process for home buyers. Under existing law, counties can impose a $10 recording fee on certain real estate documents for the purposes of preventing real estate fraud crimes. AB661 will clarify current law and enable consistent application of the real estate fraud fee in all of our 58 counties, reducing delays in recording documents and providing fairness and equity for homeowners. This bill is supported by the county records offices throughout the state and has no opposition. I request your aye votes.
Mr. Jones, you're recognized.
Mr. Speaker, I know we're trying to get out here quickly today, so I'll try to be quick. I have a question for the author, please.
Without objection.
Mr. Mathis, is this your first bill on the floor?
Indeed it is, so take your best shot.
You know what? I'm kind of confused about the language of the bill. I was reading through the language. I think there's about four pages of language, and the title of the bill says it's about real estate. But there's a lot of language in there about recording, instruments. There's an auditor, which is defined as one who listens. And then there's a part in there about CCR, which I don't know what Clearwater Creedence Revival has to do with this bill. Or Creedence Clearwater Revival. So could you explain for the members of the assembly, is this a music bill or a real estate bill?
Members, obviously this is a real estate bill, and I don't know how long ago it was that my colleague, Mr. Jones, bought his house, but I purchased mine about 2 years ago, and this process can be very confusing at times. So maybe he should go back and talk to his realtor and everybody and read through a few more things.
Mr. Jones.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm going to ignore the accusations from my freshman colleague from the Central Valley. And still, you know, as a licensed real estate agent myself, who has some understanding of the real estate laws and you know the things that he's trying to convince us to vote for, despite him trying to talk me out of voting for his bill, I'm going to vote aye.
Mr. Wilk, you're recognized.
Yes, I want to commend the author for this bill. I too am a big fan of CCR, and I have a question of the author.
Without objection.
I'd like to know what your favorite Creedence Clearwater Revival song is.
I might have to get a time machine to go back to hear that one. So I request for your aye votes.
Mr. Wagner, you are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. All right, so this first bill, the author seems to be prepared and he's willing to tangle with a real estate agent. So I got a question of the author. As I read through the bill, you're exempting out transfers subject to section 11911 of the Revenue and Taxation Code. Please, sir, what exactly does section 11911 of the Revenue and Taxation Code say that you're amending? Oh, question of the author.
Without objection.
Thank you.
Mr. Mathis, you could choose to answer that now or in your close.
Members will move forward for the close. Thank you.
On my own time, we are really looking forward to that close. And I hope you'll take a chance to look it up while you're being asked the question by the next speaker. Members, I've looked it up. I'm not going to tell you what it is. I don't want to spoil the close. But this is a good bill. I'd urge an aye vote.
Mr. Linder.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Question the author.
Without objection.
Considering the dock stamps in each county are typically about $1.10 per thousand, the question that I have is, in the county that you live in, what are the dock stamps and what is your favorite CCR song?
Mr. Mathis, you may answer that question or choose to address any of these matters in your close.
Members, as was requested earlier, I will move towards my close so that you can all catch your flights.
Seeing and hearing no further debate, this is the time, Mr. Mathis, for your close.
Members, I respectfully ask for your aye vote. All questions can be answered in my office later.
And with that, the clerk will open the roll. All members vote who desire to vote. All members vote who desire to vote. All members vote who desire to vote. The clerk will close the roll and tally the votes. Ayes 69, no 0. The measure passes.